Okay, YouTube, I got the first light here modified. I used 2 3 position and 1 5 position Wago connectors. You could probably use wire nuts, or you could probably also solder and heat shrink these wires, as I have the black for the ceiling light, and I just chose the 2 red wires to connect together. And then this is the black for the night light. There's just 2 wires, the black in and the black out. And then this is the neutral connection. So you've got the neutral coming in, and then the white going out is the neutral for the night light. And then the blue I just chose as the neutral for the GX24 connector. And then over here, you can see this is the 6-pin plug. Here's the top 2 are the night light, black and white. And then you've got the 2 red wires, 2 blue wires. And then this is the GX24 socket. And I forget which goes where, but there's 2 red wires on one side, 2 blue wires on the other side. And I just take my little GX24 8-watt LED and I flip the switch. There, we got light. So that was pretty easy. And you just get rid of the whole ballast right here. You don't need it at all. In fact, I'll show you what it looks like. Yeah, so this is the old ballast. I just cut the black, 2 whites, and then the 2 reds and 2 blue wires off. This was the CFL wires, and then this was the 120 volt wires. About $100 right there. I might try to maybe put that up for sale, because that's a very hard part to find, and I hear they are prone to burning out quite frequently. I don't feel much heat off of there. So I think what I will do is I'll put the cover back on this light, and we'll see how it heats up when it runs. So that's one option. And there's my other option I'm going to test. This is the 10.5-watt Philips high CRI bulb. And there you go. That is that bulb. It is pretty bright. Wow. Just to see there. But yeah, I will put the cover on and see how hot these bulbs get.